which is the first chapter is role and purpose of accounting. The first thing that we'll be studying is understand the need for financial information, or how do we define basically accounting. So the first thing that we will be explaining is what is the meaning of accounting. So accounting is basically a recording of financial transactions. The first thing in accounting is a recording of all the financial transactions. Second part of accounting information is that we analyze the information. It relates to what aspect. And the third part is we make certain decisions and we communicate the same information to the right person. Recording of the information, then analyzing the same financial information, communicate the information to the right people, and some people say that it is that information that we have gathered, we have recorded, we have analyzed, it helps you make certain financial decisions. So anyway, both of these things are correct as far as accounting definition is concerned. Financial and management accounting. What is the difference between financial and management accounting? Now, all those informations that are required by law an accountant is doing inside the organization, updating the records of finance, updating the records of accounting information, financial information, that relates to financial information. Now, it might be concerned to many of the institutions. Government may require this, the revenue department may require this, internal management may require this, and external people, other stakeholders may require this. However, that information which is solely for the purpose of internal management, like the owner, the managers who require this information, the employees may require this information. So that information which is not required by external people or other stakeholders, only required by the management of that organization, of the business, solely for decision-making purpose, costing purpose, or many other reasons. So that is called management account. Broadly, we can define financial accounting is concerned with the preparation of financial statements, covering the whole of the activities of the business for use by external users. This area of accounting is normally regulated by law. And the management accounting is concerned itself with the parts of the business as well as the whole, and is used to help decision making by internal users, such as those in management. The main objective is planning and control. Accounting is basically divided into two major parts: financial accounting and management accounting. Who are the users of financial accounting? So as I told earlier, it might be used by the revenue departments, the tax authorities, by the government. It may be used by the competitors. It may be used by your suppliers. It may be used by the banks or the financial institutions. It may be used by many other people. So external as well as internal users may use it for any purpose, for decision making purpose, for investment purpose, for any kind of information they want to seek about the financial situation of that company. Is basically those people can use this information. However, internal management might only be interested in knowing what is the profit, what is the costing. So the costing is done by the managers. External people might not be interested in what is the cost of the good, or how you manufacture it, and what are the steps to manufacture it, and they might not be interested. They might only be interested in what is the price of the good. So as long as you want internal information, so you are not dealing with this, but rather you are dealing with the management accountant. Now, who would be the stakeholders of the information?
So the first part is owners. Owners of the company, owners of the business, they are the people who need maximum information because they have to make certain decisions. They want to spread their business, they want to start new ventures, they want to see what is happening in the business, what is the amount of profit, how much is the loss, why we are having a profit, how can we increase the percentage of the profit, what is loss and how can we decrease the loss. And these are all information that they need to make certain decisions about the business. So the first concerned party in this case is the owners. Then we know that the bankers may need, because if you want to take a loan from the bank, so certainly bankers would need many informations, including the plan of the business, the cash flow statement of the business, statement of comprehensive income. They will require you future plans, all these informations they will require you. They may require, if you have taken another loan from them, they may also require you. Trade creditors. Now, why do trade creditors, look at this, trade creditors, why do they need any kind of information? Trade creditors may require before giving you any kind of credit. So they may require this information, that what is the worthiness of the company. Should we deal with this company or we should not deal with the company? Long-term creditors. Now, this may be financial institutions, this may be any third party which want to deal with you, what is happening with the financial situation of the company. So they might be interested to see, should we continue doing business with this company or not? Customers of the company. Obviously, they are dealing with, when we are going to deal with any of the company, so we must know what kind of company is this, what is the situation of this company, are they manufacturing good products, are they providing good services or not. So customers are always likely to get information about the company. Competitors want to know how other companies in the same business are doing. Are they making any profit? Are they making profit that bigger than us? Are we making, or they themselves, are they making more profit than their competitors? What is the situation of the company and how do they deal in the whole industry? So it gives them a chance where they are and how they must go. So this is what the whole idea is. Why do the competitors need the information? Had I been a businessman, so I would like to know what is my situation as compared to my peers, the other people who are in the same industry, who are in the same thing. So I would like to know, are they making more profit? And, or I'm making the more profit. And if they are making the more profit, what is the reason I cannot get that profit? What wrong I am doing, which is basically hindering me to get that profit. Then there is this analyst and or advisor. Most of the big companies these appoint an analyst. They have to see how the performance of the business was in the preceding year, and they, in the light of the information that they get with the financial information, they recommend certain suggestions. They figure out the problems, the loopholes in that, and they suggest certain corrective actions for the company to do. And then there are some advisors, you know, what can be done in this situation, how to figure out the problem, how to solve the issue, how to proceed it. They have, unless they have this information, they cannot proceed with certain suggestions. So that is one of the core group where information is needed, and they can always suggest you. And most of the big companies are having these analysts or advisors, and they are paid highly for doing this job. Now, one of the stakeholders is government. Why would government be interested in what I am doing? Government is interested to know how much profit is being made, because they want to take their part in that. They want to take a certain revenue or the tax collection on the basis of the profit that I have done. The VAT implications are there. So there are many other things that the government is basically doing, and they have to look after the figures of the different
financial institutions, they have to take care of all these things. And they also, government needs this information for future planning, for development of the industry, for the development of the trade, for the development of the commerce section. So they have to see what is happening with a particular trade or with a particular industry, what is happening with that.